Panda? Hi, Panda. Right, so today, we're talking about the Sodapup dog toys, and the Sodapup dog toys actually our favorite ones. So we have different ones we use daily, and these ones definitely are part of this. So we use mainly these ones on a day-to-day setting, or at least weekly. And these are their Can dog toys. So they look like super cool, like cans, you know, the ones you would use. They come in super cute shapes, like the cupcake, a doggy coffee cup, as well as this super cute honey bear. However, Panda, that is not all, is it? No, that's not all. Because the Sodapup dog toys are not just incredibly cute, but they are also, shall we tell the other benefits? Yes? Okay. They're incredibly tough toys. So if you have a power chewer, she's so delicious. Just look at her. So if you have a power chewer who likes to chew, especially if you have a bully breed like I do, having said that though, Rambo's not too much of a chewer, but if you have a younger one, or generally a Wadi dog like I have, then you would probably value something that is lasting, that is actually durable, and that is done in a way that is ethical and in no form or way hurtful to your dog. Still, you want to obviously supervise the use of it, but they have a really, like, they are really cute dog toys. And if you have seen our video on interactive dog toys, if you haven't seen it, I will link it down below in the description box. But if you have seen the video, you know that we use this cupcake, or if you follow us on Instagram, you see this quite often, and they're incredibly cute. However, they also have a really nice form to grab, and they are quite big. So I'll show you on her face. So she is a medium-sized dog. Excuse, yummy, huh? Is your favorite, one of your favorites. She's only interested if there's food in it. However, you can see just from the portion. Panda, can I have a look? Can you have a look? Yes? Ooh. So you can see it's quite a big one. They can't easily, by any chance or accident, just swallow this. This will come in a smaller size too. However, it's still relatively, like, this one is the large one, it's relatively big. The opening's very different to the Kong or anywhere where it's very easy to just fall out for treats or wet food. This one is slightly different, you can see. And then these ones would have a very big opening. So these ones are quite easy for my dog, so we just use them for their normal food and just have them filled with wet food if I just want something quick for them. So you can vary them, you can freeze them. I've popped them hundreds of times already in the dishwasher. And as I said, we have them in daily use and they are still in really, really good shape. My dogs are not like super power chewers, so they would prefer to chew on something that is actually edible. So something like a pig ears or whatever. Still pretty good condition. So yes, really nicely done. It is made in the States. So if you're in the UK as I am, you can order these from different shops. I will have them in my shop soon too. Otherwise, if you're in the States, you can order them directly from the Sodapup webpage, and you can save 10% with the code BULLYCO, which is my code. So I will earn a little commission. However, you just pay the normal price, and I only recommend products that I truly, genuinely love. So we use them with or without discount codes or without affiliate codes, affiliate money, etc. Because they are generally really, really good. So I already mentioned durability, and if you are on their webpage, you can see the graph. And this one is pretty durable. As you can see, we use this regularly and there's still like nothing like used. So you can easily pop in like treats too. It's in, can't fall off. It could, but they have to work properly.
Get it, yes, yeah. Get it, yeah, yes.
So you can easily keep them busy with this. Get girly, yes, push. And you can see with her, she's very gentle. She doesn't just like eat it or chew it. However, she will be pushing it, and it's a really nice size. You can now see,
yes, good girl, push, prima.
How big it is actually for her size. Back to durability. So these toys, they're generally very durable toys. However, they would also come in a magnum size, and this is usually the black ones. So if you see any Sodapup toys that have black coloring, then these are for maximum chewers or for heavy chewers. So I can't push this down with my hand. I can make a tiny like dip in it. So if you have a dog who's really smart and this is a bit frozen, they can squeeze it out, but you can see it doesn't really move like that much.
So these are generally quite durable. However, the Magnum ones or the black ones are even more durable. They also come in puppy colors, so for puppies with a bit of like a soft chew. Another thing that for me is really relevant and that is really important is that these toys or the toys I give to my dogs, that they are generally safe. And by safe, I not only mean a choking hazard that can be prevented, but also the materials, that these are actually solid materials. And if you smell at them, they don't smell like this toxic plastic some do. If you order them from some big retailers online, they might have this really sticky plastic smell when they come from mass production. So they have none of this. And I read it out actually from the webpage. So they are BPA free, non-toxic plastic. And they say, safety is our top concern and we have developed, hello sweetheart, the safest non-toxic rubber toys on the market, or rubber toy material on the market. Not only does it have high tier strengths to resist destruction, it's also FDA compliant, BPA, and, oh god, I don't know if I can say this, phthalate free, passes Prop 65 testing and is easy on the planet. So whatever this means, you might be a chemist, you might know better. So you can pop them in the dishwasher on the top rack, and they are lasting, they are non-toxic, and they are safe. So for me, this is something that is really relevant. It might not be as relevant for you, however, if you have dogs, you might want to give it some thought on what you actually put in your household. Also, if you are environmentally friendly or concerned with sustainability, then this might be something to think about for you as well. Another thing I like about the Sodapup dog toys, and again, like this all might not be the most relevant for you if you just are looking for cute things to add to your household for your dog, then the main selling point is that these are incredibly durable, that they are super cute, and that they're non-toxic. However, if you are like me, a rescue dog mom, then you might find the next reason super interesting too. And this is that they give back to charity. So what Sodapup does is they donate dog products related to dog charities. And this could be shelters, and this is done through their Rescue 2 program. And for me, as I said, big selling point, because as my channel title suggests, I'm a dog mom, I'm a rescue dog mom, and rescue to me is the absolute best breed. So absolute pro-rescue over here, and definitely one reason for me also to just support them. But it's more for me a benefit or like an extra, because I love their products, I generally love them, and I think, yeah, this is just a bonus. If you would like to learn more about their materials and also what they are made of, I pop down a link to their webpage where you can find more information about the materials they use. And generally, as I said, if you have a power chewer, if you have a bully breed, and as you maybe know, I'm a big bully breed advocate. So if you have a power chewer, if you have one dog with a big jaw, then this might be definitely an option for you. And they are great alternatives to a Kong as well. And generally also amazing products that are very cute, very flexible, and just, incredibly amazing. So, gonna check them out. They are, especially the Magnum ones, they have added elasticity, they're tear resistant, and they're just really nice alternative, especially if you have, and you know this, if you have an exam bully or something else, that it can be really difficult to find appropriate chews for these kind of dogs or for any power chew out there. So I would highly recommend you're going to check them out. They also do toys, so they also have incredibly toys for play or for training, the ones with a handle. I don't have any of these yet, so I will get my hands on them in the future for training Panda. However, yeah, all the interactive dog toys we have used some of their ligmats, and I will introduce them in another video, but I highly, highly recommend them. If you have any Sodapup toys, please do let me know which are your favorites, and I will see you next time. Thank you and take care. Bye-bye.